not a problem, this is not a Father's Day. I just want to point that out. Sorry. Okay. But I don't usually try and give background knowledge on my spoken words before I do that. I'm just going to give a little bit. One holiday, well, if you guys didn't know that, I'm in foster care. One holiday I was feeling kind of down because I didn't have another family with me. But I thank God that he gave me a mindset not to feel down all the time and pick myself up. I'm not going to use this because I'm going to use my kids. And I'm going to.
Being strong for the little girl yearning for a mother figure, filled with misconception and loneliness, with no desire to crave, to thirst, to hold on to what she is, but let go of what she feels. And the distinction between the two, whether she comes home to her or whether she comes home to you, what empty voids filled with lies and deception has she filled with her heart, as she's yearning for a family, for a long-body friend. What else is there left to fill but recession? No love, but complete condemnation, sorrow in her heart, no recitation of her proclamation. I am love, and there will always be a situation where I will have love. There will never be a temptation greater than the sweet sin I indulge in. Don't have pity on me, complete consent to me taking you in every single decision I'm in, I take in consideration that the love I have for each is not the love they have for me, but a yearning to be complete. Being prideful when a young girl was out of poverty, what other love is there left to make her feel like a woman? The complete package isn't what she has, but she'll take what she can grab to fill the holes and feels instead of mourning the beautiful song her father never sung her in her ear, letting her know that she is defined by the beauty inside, not the seat between her thighs with incredible intellectual heart.
All right.
Reality hits me, and at the end of the day, I realize that God is all I have. As I struggle to get on my knees to give him the proper thanks for the life of a lesson he has given me, to be the piece of art he has given me, molding me, sculpting me, shaping me into the beautiful black intellectual being he has granted me. Not with the capital A, but with the capital P, for the power of art he allows to cultivate my thoughts. Articulating my grammar and letting the words flow through my mouth, like the sway of sweet mayflowers with a capital W, but the wisdom he allows to live inside of my womb. That every chance he gives me, I birth into the world a new word for the discouraged. A new word for the discouraged, and she, in fact, herself is discouraged. That 4 a.m. as she tosses and turns to finally pick up a pen and give herself some courage. To understand the logic, to piece together the symbolic pieces of this unfamiliar puzzle. No longer looking for herself, but looking at herself with unforgiving eyes that doesn't search for demise, but waiting for the day she has structured her life. Where her feet are planted to the ground of faith, and her love, her arms as still as the love she's always craved. Not the love that won't show the way, I won't say the day, but the love, that love, that will never fade. That love that won't tell the secrets of yesterday and keep the secrets of tomorrow hidden in a place where love won't stray away. A love that will look me in my face, tell me the God-given truth and won't turn me straight away from the golden gates. But love me every single minute, every single second, of every single day.
At this time, we will have Elder Marlisa with the awards.